Welcome to the Michigan Golfer Show. Join us each week as we explore the people, the places, and the events that shape our great game.
Welcome back to the Michigan Golfer Internet Show. My name is Tim High, and I'm sitting here with my good friend Michael Patrick Shields, also known as His Royal Highness.
Nice
Michael,
to see you.
It is great to see you too, and it's so good to see that after a long line of books, you've got a coffee table book.
At long last, eh? Yes. Some photographs to take the place of my words.
Well, whatever works, right, Michael? Tell us about the book.
Well, I'm really happy. It's a handsome book. It's the history of Arthur Hill's almost 200 golf courses that he's done in the U.S. and elsewhere. And it was good education to write the book because I learned a lot about design and I learned a lot about the challenges that go into building a golf course. And I don't know if it'll translate into better on-course strategy for myself, but it should. It should.
Just knowing more about architecture.
Just knowing, yeah, where the ball's supposed to go and how the designer built the hole with a, you know, with a certain path intended, or maybe the options that you have that you might not recognize.
All right. Well, where's the book available?
Wherever books are sold, but mainly at Arthur Hill's Design Golf Courses, and also at Amazon.com or ArthurHills.com would probably be the best place.
All right, and there are many of those golf courses in the state of Michigan.
There sure are, some of the peaches.
And they are, and name some of the ones that people might not know that Art Hills was the backer of, or the backbone of.
Well, I'll tell you a funny story. The first time I met him, Arthur Hills, was at a golf course he was opening in Miami. And as you know, his headquarters is in Toledo. And I said to Arthur, I just played one of your original courses in Toledo, Brandywine. And he said to me, well, I didn't know too much about what I was doing when I built that course. And I was overcome by the candid nature of the fella. And but if you go to courses like Daily Fee course, like Riverview Highlands, I mean, everybody knows about Bay Harbor and the Double JJ Ranch and some of the more popular ones, but I think you'll find if you go to the Daily Fee places and you'll see that the courses are highly playable and fun.